Just got turned. Mine got turned. Mine got turned. Wait. Oh, okay, there we go. I was like, why is this being like this? Sick. Okay. Perfect. Now I'm gonna do this really cool thing where I actually start recording.
Okay.
Are you proud of me, David? Okay.
Welcome back once again to The Whore Next Door. I am Molly Stewart, your favorite naked neighbor. Wow, I haven't said that one in a while. And we have returning guest, beautiful Lexi K. How are you, my dear?
I am doing pretty well. Thank you so much for having me back.
Of course. What have you been up to since we freaking last hung out? How long has it even been? I thought it was, what, July? Was it July?
No.
No.
August?
September? Maybe
the first week of September, if
I
that,
even,
or the end of August. It was around that time.
It was around that time, but oh my God. So how have things been going in the sphere of content creation for you?
Lately, very, very well, actually. I take that back. Content creation, not as much, but my lives have been really fantastic. Super fun. My audience is getting very big. I'm starting to know the people who are coming to watch me, which is really cool.
So you can like put faces and personalities and names to the people who are just otherwise faceless creatures.
Exactly. Which it makes it a lot cooler, honestly. Like when I have somebody coming back and they're like starting to get to know me and they're like, oh, Lexi, what up? How was Vegas or whatever it is? I'm like, oh, we kind of. Kind of friends.
Oh, you
I don't
give
know.
It. You give
yeah,
a shit a little bit. That's cool.
Yes, I like that. That's really cool. So
that's awesome.
My community is growing, I'll say.
Well, that's really good. Mm-hmm. What's been like? What do you think's been currently the most challenging thing in the past couple months since like starting this off? Because you, the funny thing is, you kind of started this shortly around the time that I started this as well. Two different kind of journeys. I'm just kind of curious.
It's
like
true.
What that's been like for you, because I know like going into it you just had a lot of questions and uncertainty and weren't even sure if you were gonna like keep doing it or do it at all, and you were kind of just like up in the air about it. So has that like changed at all? Or
like I'm trying to find my little place, like my niche, and I think I was confused for a while and struggling a little bit. But I think that now that I'm getting more comfortable, not only behind the camera, on my lives, everything, it's starting to show and my confidence is coming out and I'm starting to feel more sure of myself. And what that really meant was I'm concentrating a little less on, like, I felt a lot of pressure to make content. I felt a lot of pressure to do certain things that I was putting on myself. Like, the only person that was pressuring me was myself. And I just really love entertaining. So I really have been concentrating more on the lives and, of course, putting out content too. But
yeah, for sure. And we talked about that the last time that you were on.
Yeah.
As well. As I had a moment of panic. So the last episode, as some of you may or may not know, if you regularly listen to the show, I forgot to start recording the microphone until like halfway through the entire show. So I had a moment where the GoPro was mid-blink and I was like, is it not recording?
Oops.
But I think we're all good. So we're going to continue. But yeah, we were saying that last time that it was all about like the entertainment aspect of it. And that's, you know, what drew you into the job that you had before, and like whether it was influencing or whether it was dancing on TikTok or whatever, you know, and you just kind of come from a performing background, especially with the dance background that you have and all that. So it's good that you've kind of like found your center in that, because it's like we talked about, it doesn't have to be the same thing for everybody who does it. And you can just find where you fit in best and where you're the most comfortable and where you thrive the most creatively. So
I think that is a problem that a lot of new creators have, trying, like, I feel like everyone kind of starts off trying to do what they see other people doing, like, just to figure it out.
Well, of course.
You know,
and
like,
also you have to try
place.
To, you always hear that you have to follow the trends and you have to stay relevant to what's popular. And it's like, but because of what's trending, I feel like a lot of creativity gets lost inside of that, because, you know, just because you're trying to get the views so that people can see the things that you have to offer. But then sometimes you're sucked into the cycle of just creating the things that you know will be popular, you know, simply for the sake of hopefully by proxy bringing awareness to the other things that you do as well.
Exactly.
So it's a difficult line to trudge.
Mm-hmm. What about you? How has it been going since the start? You've done so many episodes since
we have a green screen now.
Very professional.
David, you can show how green it is. Show them how green. Now put the thing back. And then I got this thing. Wait, put it back when I do this. You're editing. So look at this thing that I got. Explosion. I don't know. So one thing that's been cool for me with the podcast is like there's GoPros. I feel kind of like fancy and shit. I'm like, I'm not going anywhere. I'm just sitting here, but I feel like I'm doing something active. but it's
you can pretend to be active because there's so many GoPros.
Yeah, I feel like it's definitely definitely helped me be able to talk to people a lot better. Plus, David has gotten pretty sick at editing. It's been cool to hand that off to him because I feel like I was overanalyzing things so much when I was the one doing it all myself. I'm like, I'm doing everything, but I don't have to do everything. Mm-hmm. And so David's been freaking awesome. I like the random things that he throws in here because when I watch it later, it just cracks me up.
It gives it some extra spice. It really does.
It's like there bringing is like the style of YouTubing, but to a podcast.
Yeah.
Which anyone who is just an audio only listener, if you ever want to watch the video episodes, you can go to you can't go there.
Don't go there.
Mother. All right. So today's strain has been brought to you by Cannabative. This is the Acai mini motivator. It's the tits pajamas.
It's definitely fabulous because I couldn't talk there either.
I thought you were going to say February. What are we doing? YouTube.com/MollyStewartChat so you guys can watch us make fools of ourselves.
My face is probably so red right now. You have to go to YouTube to see it.
I think it's so fun, though. I like watching it later because it's funny because, in essence, we're just sitting here and it's just you and me at a table. And technically, we're kind of performing in some manner, but not really.
Yeah.
Because it's just a conversation that happens to be funny because we're f***ing awesome.
We are. We so are.
But then, like, reviewing it later and being able to sit in and listen to that conversation,
You hear it a different way.
You hear it a different way. And I think that it's been fun to kind of, I know I talked about this on the last one, but now I have somebody here to sit and talk to, with. Anyway, so, it's cool to be able to kind of just see what came out of what kind of started nowhere. Like, I'm asking you.
I mean, this is huge.
I mean,
look at all your professional equipment. This is like real deal now.
This is not professional.
She's lying.
Goddamn professional.
No, this is awesome. Like, I mean, hopefully you kind of look at me the same way. I don't know, but I think it's really cool that I got to see this grow, you know, like maturing.
Yeah. And I think it's been cool because, like, so you and I met in a way that had nothing to do with what we're doing now at this very moment.
True.
Like, it was under the most random circumstances that it came to happen that I met you. Mm-hmm. And then to just kind of like watch you grow, like even as much as I know you now, I still don't even know you that well. We live so far away and we talk, but it's like, it's like those people that tell you that they're in love with you and they've never even met you in person. And you're just like, bruh,
you don't even know.
Come on now. It's like, you can only be so close with someone that you only have like a phone conversation with. But even then, we've had such meaningful conversations via text or even phone call or our Snapchat messages back and forth.
Thank God for those Snapchat messages.
But it's been cool to, because I think I've even watched you grow and gain more confidence than definitely when I first met you. Like, it was funny because I think when we first shot photos together, our mutual friend, I'm not going to say her name. Actually, I think I can because she's said that she wants to actually come on the podcast and talk about workshops. So that's Tina. Great.
Yeah, Tina.
Tina, if you ever watch this, I hope that you do because I mean this in the most loving way. But when we first shot photos together, you reminded me of Tina. And don't get me wrong. All right, now hear me out.
Uh-oh.
It's just because,
Tina,
you are so sweet. the sweetest, most innocent person. I want to corrupt you so very badly, and I've been doing my best.
I feel the same way, Tina. I feel the same way.
But you're like this, right? And I know that this is you and stuff, but you were so timid.
Yeah.
And you were so, oh, and we weren't even doing anything.
Yeah.
And it was freaking adorable. And then I watched
I'm shy.
You. But then I watched you come out even more, like with the photos that we did with Allie and Charlize. And like that was even a huge barrier breakthrough for you there. And I think it's cool to watch you be able to see yourself in a way that's like a more positive light, especially when a lot of people think that this job or even this broad scope of work that we do is degrading. Because I think it can be, but I think any job can be.
Any job
but
can
I've
be.
Watched you and so many other people, including myself, blossom and grow through this line of work. And so I think that that's pretty awesome to fucking behold.
It is pretty awesome. Growth is awesome. You know, it's not cool to stay the same all the time forever.
It's boring.
Very boring.
Oh, I also have hats because it's Christmas month. So we should put these on.
Okay. Oh no. Over the trying to no.
It's not gonna work.
It's not gonna work. We could pretend that
my
it
head
works.
Is too big.
It's because we gotta put these over.
Oh my god, you're so right. Got this. We got this, guys. Don't worry.
We got this. Okay, here we go. There, and then put these on.
I have a fucking big ass head.
There you go. How
ridiculous does this look? Probably I've never felt cuter in my life. Let me see.
Let's see. Okay, not bad.
All right.
We had to take a quick selfie break just now.
Yeah, we're women.
Sorry, guys. That's
sorry. What we do. Yeah. I mean, who doesn't take just a bunch of selfies anymore? No. I feel like a lot of people do that.
We kind of have to. Stay relevant.
I get so tired. I hate going into
selfies.
My face.
I take so many pictures of myself.
There's so many that you have to fucking take. It's so dumb. I have tried to clear out my phone so many times and just like back it up to other stuff, but it's like you have to take so many photos. And like it's fun, like it's cool, like for photo shoots.
But how photo shoot ones are cool, but that's not a selfie. That's not technically like, a selfie, though. Bro, that's like a cool photo shoot.
I get tired of fucking looking at myself all the time. I'm like, how do you guys enjoy this? How do you jerk off to this like all the time? Like, clearly you have to have some other side OnlyFans that you're subscribed to for shizzle, because I cannot look at myself this much all the time. How do you do it?
I have a new favorite TikTok, actually. It was this beautiful young lady, and it was the elf sound where it's like, oh, okay guys, Santa's coming tomorrow, and he's like, Santa, mm-hmm. I know him, you know.
Yeah.
And she's like, every time I take my bra off, and like my girlfriend, you know, even though she sees my tits a million times a day, yeah. every single yeah. day, it's like, ah, every time.
You guys are you guys make my job easy. You're like,
oh, yes, again,
this angle, same titties, slightly different time of day. Show. And I appreciate that.
Yeah.
Because, like, we can't do photo shoots all the time. It's so hard on your body. I've been doing so many and I'm so sore. And I have not been skipping gym day. And I'm like, dude.
Okay, let me ask you. You've been doing a lot of new stuff. What's the favorite thing that you've done in the past month and a half?
I have a 6-pack of abs.
Well, okay. That's awesome. Okay, yes. But I meant, like, your photo shoot-wise, artistically, creatively, what's your favorite thing?
Right. fuck. LaCroix. That's ridiculous. David, you can cut that out. Or leave it in. I don't fucking know. How do I even want to portray myself?
Oh, my God.
Do you ever know? I never know how I'm supposed to be perceived, because sometimes I watch my live streams and it's like one way. And I watch my content and it's like a totally different way. And I'm like, oh, I'm like this sexy thing. But then I'm like on cam and I just rant
you're,
about everything.
You're normal.
Like, it's like this, you, but with you boobs. Yourself.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. I don't know what I'm supposed to be, but I'm tired of pretending. And sometimes you have gas. I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah. We're human.
Eat my dick. Now.
Eat my dick.
So, do you have anything?
You didn't answer the question.
What did I not answer?
Your favorite.
Oh, fuck.
I mean, just the other day you did something that I thought was really fucking cool. I'm not going to say it.
I can't really talk about it yet.
Yeah, I'm not going to talk about it.
I've already released.
Yes.
So, my 30th birthday video was pretty fucking awesome. That was really fun. But I think one of my favorites was we did a Halloween scene with Madison Ivy, Jada Kai, and moi. Mm-hmm. And we did a Alice in Wonderland shoot.
Yeah.
So that was very, very, very fun. And I like that. And it came out so beautifully. My friend Marcos Rivera shot it. And it was really, really cool. So if you guys haven't seen it, it's on the fans only. So Naked Barbie doll. All right. So moving on.
Yes.
Fuck, I'm so stoned right now.
Uh-oh. She's stoned.
Are you stoned?
I am. Which says a lot because, okay, guys, I am a very heavy smoker.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'm like, when I smoke, I'm just normal. I don't feel like I'm high anymore. Yeah,
that's why I smoke the motivator.
Yo, I'm high right now.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Like, that's why I love the motivators. And it doesn't take a lot. Those are little minis.
Those are very small. And we were sharing
it. I'm going to send some home with you because they gave me so many. Thank you, Cannovative.
Thank you.
For sponsoring me with weed. We're not selling anything, by the way. Mm. We're not selling anything.
Nope.
We're not endorsing anything. I'm just thanking them for the supply. That's all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciated.
Appreciated. All right. But as I was saying, do you have anything like upcoming that you're super excited to start trying out or anything like in the works?
Possibly. I'm not sure if I should talk about it on here or not.
That's okay. We don't have to.
But I will talk about something else.
Would you like to talk about your craziest sexual experience?
That's a very good question. Mm. But hold on. Let's backtrack a second.
Okay. We'll work our way back.
So something that I don't remember if we talked about last time or not, but I did talk to you about, was the fact that I didn't really want to do a lot of yoga or bendy stuff necessarily on my fans page.
Mm-hmm.
I've changed my mind about that.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Why? Because I don't know why I have this thing where I fight against the things that I'm good at. Why, if I'm good at something, why am I not utilizing it?
It's because you want to be the best at the thing and you're being judged on a public forum at the opinion of random strangers on the internet. And so you're worried that because potentially you're not the very best at what you're doing because you're a perfectionist, it's your constant worry. You don't want to do it because you're afraid you're going to be judged on it and it's not going to be up to everybody else's standards, but most especially not up to your own.
She might be right. I want to look good. I want to make sure I look good.
But you do. So.
Yeah. So I really think that I'm going to be offering a lot more of that. I'm going to be posting more of that. You know, in the past, I've gotten a lot of compliments. And I don't know why that drove me away from doing it. That should be the opposite. Like thing, you know. Then I feel like maybe because I got too many compliments, like you said, I got too many compliments, and now it's like, oh my god, they expect so much of me.
Yeah, like what if I fuck it up?
What if I fuck it up now?
But the funny thing is what's cool about having people that, you know, find you through whatever reason that they like you is that when you try new things, they already support you. So a majority of them that are going to basically pay to subscribe to a fan site are people that are already kind of invested in what you're doing. So for the most part, you can expect that feedback is mostly going to be positive and encouraging when you try to do something new. And I've even found that posting things like bloopers or just, you know, me fucking something up at the same time, or like the cooking videos that I make where I just rant about having to cook, like those things are still appreciated and requested. And because they just want you and the personality, you know, and then when you kind of can use that encouragement to push yourself to do better at those other things, then they're also encouraging you there. So it's, you know, pretty cool and well-rounded. You just have to let them in a little bit.
Yes. Yeah, so that's something that's going to be kind of new on there, but I have been, I think since we spoke last, I'm on a more like defined live streaming schedule, so I stick to that and I'm loving it. So come see me live.
Yeah, I have
Come
to
see me
support her
live.
live. What is your username there?
Lexi K, same as my fans page. I go live there too. It's so fun. I just love doing
Yeah.
it.
But enough work. Let's talk
Yes.
about things that are fun.
Yes.
Why don't you tell me something? What is the weirdest thing that's ever happened to you sexually? If you're comfortable talking about it and it's not traumatic. And I'm not talking like bad, I'm just talking weird.
Weird things. Oh my God. Okay. This isn't weird, maybe. I don't know if it's weird or not, but it was very embarrassing.
Tell me.
Okay. Because it was like I was pretty young at the beginning of my sexual career. And I was at my boyfriend's dorm and we had sex. And then he left to go to the bathroom and clean up. And he came back and he was like, what happened to the condom? And I was like, what do you mean? What happened to the condom?
Oh no.
So, yeah, it like came off of him inside me. And that might have been the weirdest thing that ever happened. I mean,
Why didn't it come?
everything ended up being fine and nothing bad happened. I just like reached in and took it out and was like,
Oh,
that's fucking weird.
yeah, that's
Yeah,
gross.
that's weird. So, I guess that's the weirdest thing that's ever happened to me, probably.
Oh.
Yeah. And I guess that's probably not even that weird. That probably is pretty, I
Oh.
don't know.
You're so cute.
What about you? What's the weirdest thing?
Oh, well.
Probably way weirder than that.
I don't know if I'm supposed to share while I'm talking about it in
Oh. Well,
therapy.
not that. Well, not that.
I don't know. I've just I had a lot of bad sex.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just for like a long time. Some were kind of funny though. Think. There was one guy who sounded like a turtle when he
What?
came.
What?
Yeah, have you like the turtle humping the shoe?
Oh,
I think I've
yeah.
talked
We've talked
about
to
this
me.
before.
You have.
Like, but like I think I've talked about it on here because I'm pretty sure David put a picture of turtles humping shoes in here. But yeah, so that guy was fucking weird.
That's weird.
Yeah, there was just a lot of fucking like dark stuff,
Well,
you
not
know?
that. Yeah, no,
No.
not that.
It's not as good. There was this one guy who, though, as soon as I got naked, he came. That was pretty funny. And then the
Like, oops, okay.
Yeah, and then oh, but the fucking worst part though is like when they try to just keep like it's fine. That happens all the time. Like, what? And then you can keep going. No, you can't. It's flat. It looks like someone sucked all the custard out of an eclair. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? You can't get that inside of me. It's not a cavern, it's a slit. Like, it's like, what do you expect to happen?
Oh
It's like trying to put a pancake like into a taco shell.
no.
How does that work?
I'm picturing all the pictures popping up on your on
Like,
the
does that sound appetizing to anyone else? Pancakes and tacos? I don't think
No,
so.
that doesn't work. No,
It doesn't work. And
That's very funny.
it's like eat my vagina or something. I love how that never occurs to men who lose an erection. They're just like, for the most part, I should say. I know this is not all men. Trust me. All right, so what I'm saying is, why does it not occur to men like eat her fucking vagina or like ask her to like blow you a little bit or something? Be like, I'm so sorry that I fucking came because you took off your clothes or
Like,
like
you're
for
so
whatever
hot. Yeah,
reason,
whatever it
just
is.
like do something. Don't just try to like mash it against her vagina. What are you doing? It's happened to me so many times
That's
that
terrible.
I'm considering it now. So I guess that's the
That's
weirdest thing.
weird.
That's the weirdest thing across the board of the men that I've had sex with is that like whether they come too early and they want to keep going or whether they're like whiskey dick or whatever and they like can't get it up. It's like just
It's
stop
fine.
mashing it
Yeah.
against my pelvis. It's basically a sense like it turns into scissoring.
All right. And that's not getting anybody off. So I don't care. Like, please stop. Thank you.
Oh my gosh.
Like, eat the pussy or snuggle. Maybe you could cuddle. Like,
Snuggle,
try
snuggle.
cuddling.
Cuddling's
Cuddling is
nice.
dope. Like,
Yeah.
cuddling is highly underrated. So sometimes if you come too early, you just need a back rub.
Yeah.
Just cuddle. It's okay. Happens to everyone at some point. All right, anyway. All right. So what about then, like, wildest sexual experience? You're like, I feel like you pretend to be this vanilla person, right? But I feel like there's something there, and I just wanna I wanna tell stories.
I would prefer not to be a vanilla person. So, like, luckily, I'm with somebody who is open to trying lots of things. And we have like probably pretty vanilla-ish stuff, but I love trying, like, and especially like role play and stuff like that. That's
Yeah.
so fucking fun.
Fuck yeah. Like, that's what I'm saying.
Oh.
Like, I'm not even saying, like, for whatever is crazy. I'm just saying I know that you're more than just missionary starfish with your
Oh,
husband. So it's like,
no.
I know that you do that stuff,
Oh
and I know that you're very sexual. And so I'm saying, talk about it. Like,
Yeah.
what's the shit that you're into? Because especially like being married and being with the same person for like such an extended period of time,
You gotta keep it
no matter what, you
spicy.
have to keep it spicy. So
Yeah.
like, how the fuck do you keep it spicy? And I think that anyone can benefit from hearing this who's in a long-term relationship or would like to be and would like to like extend the lifespan of your partnership with someone. Like, I think it's
Yes.
important to think about options and things, and because it takes two to tango.
It
So,
does. Like, the first of all,
ladies.
the first thing is like, don't be shy about talking about it with your partner. Like, 'cause that gets you nowhere. Because you both could be thinking the same thing and just not saying it.
Yeah.
And then look, you're missing out on a fun
You're
time.
missing out on some
Missing out on a fun
shit.
time.
Like, tell them what you
So,
want. Be
yes.
like, come on, hit me with a
Yeah.
brick.
And don't wait until you're like 8 years into the relationship to do it either, if you can avoid it.
No, God,
Like,
you have to tell them what you're into.
yeah, just like, don't be scared.
No, because it's better to talk about it and like get it out in the open while you can. Because
Yeah.
otherwise, like, why are you wasting everybody's time? Because so there's also a difference though between like kinks and fetishes, right?
Yes.
So like a fetish, if that's something that you have, all right, you can't use it to like fucking manipulate someone. That
No.
happened to me, and it's not fucking
Not
cool.
cool.
So, and I know that a fetish means like that's your thing that you absolutely need. Like, that's what I need to come. And all right, cool. But you have to be so open and upfront about that and really make the other person aware of like your boundaries and know what theirs are and like really respect the other person that you're with. And a lot of that comes back to like strong communication. Because if you're
Yes.
not talking about it, it's not fair to the other person. It's not fair to you. And like, why are you guys wasting each other's time? It's silly.
Be with someone that you can talk to.
Yeah, because if you can't, then you're just fucking and don't expect anything else out of it.
Yeah, and then it got that definitely gets old.
It gets boring. I think
Boring.
sex gets so much fucking better when you have a connection with someone.
Oh,
Even
for sure.
performers, for instance, that I perform with repeatedly, like certain girls that, I create content with, it gets better like every time because you start to know the other person's body. You start to like know
That comfort
what gets their
level.
spot. Yeah, you're more comfortable, like, and it gets cool, and you can be more open and be like, oh, let's try this, or like, let's do this instead, because you have that open communication. So it
Yeah.
only makes the sex fucking better. Like, just talk. It's not scary. Like, or are we fucking 5 years old? Like, we're adults. We're fucking.
We're
Talk
adults.
about
This is
it.
adult
We're
situations.
fucking out here, man.
If you're old enough and mature enough to have sex, you should be old enough and mature enough
To
to
talk
talk
about
about
it.
it.
Thank you. All right.
So
Period
yeah.
out or whatever.
So the fact that him and I are willing to talk about it and laugh about it. That's
Yeah.
the other thing. Like, don't be so serious
Sometimes
in
it's
the
fucking
bedroom.
silly. It can be fucking
Yeah.
silly.
Like, be okay with like weird stuff happening and just rolling with it and having fun and laughing with your partner. It's so
Like, all
important.
right. I understood the foot thing for like a moment, like a
Yeah.
couple, like a week or so ago when I was fucking having sex. I do that
sometimes. Oh, wait a second. You were legging some feet? Is this what all right, I was...
so
hold on a second.
I don't have a foot thing. I just I understood for a moment this part. Now hear me out. And this is why I think sex is so cool, because the more you do it, the more you explore and the more you try it. Anyway, so I was doing like a little reverse cowgirl, right? Mm-hmm. And I know I'm doing my shit right, because I start to see some motherfucker's toes curling.
Woo.
And I was like, oh, I kind of get it a little bit, because I'm like, oh. And so it's like, you know, fucking, yeah. There's so many things to explore, and I think it's cool. I think sex is fucking cool, and I don't think it's as gross or scary as people fucking pretend that it is, because everybody's fucking doing it. So why can't you talk about it and just be open with, you know, what you're into and coming to middle ground on, you know, between you and whatever partner it is? Like, just fucking explore, do some shit, but you can't do it without like being open and honest about it first, because it doesn't work.
That, all that.
I hope this lighting is still good. I'm a little stoned, so I can't tell if there's too many shadows. I'm sorry, David. If it sucks, it's all right. I think it's fine. I think I'm being paranoid about it. It comes back to that perfectionism thing. It's like, fuck. Because I feel like I'm still like riding off of the wave of the last episode not fucking recording the audio.
But it worked out. That's know, what you need to concentrate on. It worked out.
I know. I keep thinking about it. But I think like we all have those obsessive thoughts, like especially when it's something that is like directly representative of you as a person.
For sure.
Like, or at least how people, you know, see or perceive you.
Perceive you.
But it's fucking, it's rough having to be under like that direct scope all of the freaking time,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Mm-hmm.
It weighs on you after a while, but it's like if you don't commit to it and continue doing it, then you miss out on all of the good things about the job as well, because it's like, you know, you have to stay on top of all of this other stuff to get to what you value about the work. There's just so much like trudge to like
layers
or sludge to trudge through. That's what I was trying to say. I don't know what I'm trying to say.
It's a river of slime.
Yeah.
Any Ghostbuster fans out there?
Yes.
I'm sure there are.
Oh, the real Ghostbusters, please.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. I don't know. I thought it was a travesty what they did to it.
With what? The new one?
Yeah.
The newest one? Did you see the
newest one? How many Ghostbusters? Okay,
are you talking about the ladies Ghostbusters? Yes. Oh, okay, yes. Okay, yeah. No, right. there is a Ghostbusters out right now that just came out that is actually connected to our Ghostbusters,
real
Ghostbusters, and they actually did a good job with it.
Okay,
I do recommend
that's
you
good.
Seeing
that's
it.
Good, yes. At least. I just get so tired of them recycling shit again and again and again. It's like, how many times are people going
like,
to
yes.
go and watch the same things? I don't watch almost original anything
content.
Anymore.
Original content.
I only watch pretty much YouTube stuff now, or like podcast stuff, because like it all feels like the same shit. Like I can't get into like TV shows, like movies are just like, I can't even focus on it. I'd rather play a video game or something. I don't know, because it just feels like the same shit on repeat for like as long as I can remember shit.
You're right. They do a lot of recycling.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the same.
Yeah. And then after a point, it's like, how can you even really enjoy that anymore? Because it kind of takes all of the novelty and glamour out of the original stuff.
Yeah. This is how I feel about what Disney Plus is doing to, or we love to say, like, the memes.
Like, it's just fine. Talking.
This is what I feel like.
This is just opinions. This is just for laughs, just for giggles. Yeah. This is all parody, whatever legal shit that I have to say. We're just talking here. Calm down.
All the Marvel shows that they are spewing out. All of them. I'm like, can we, and the movie, like everything, it's so fast.
Can
it's
you
so
imagine?
Much.
Like,
it's like.
Like, we had to
I
wait
to like
so
this.
Long
yeah.
between stuff, but yes. that's what built up the anticipation of yes. it. That's what built up the. To have to wait to see the trailers, like, so long in between and, like, have all this build up and.
It's not
the
same
crazy. Anymore. Everything is just like now. And it's just too much information. Constantly. I mean, how are we expected to absorb all of it? Like, I fucking hate this thing so much. Like I did a photo shoot. I set it down for 30 minutes. The amount of notifications when I
It's
came back to
unreal.
it, like, and I had my girlfriend like answering a couple texts for me and stuff while I was doing it, and I'm like it's never ending, but it's like you have to also keep up with everything. But then when are we allowed to like take a step back and be like, just a minute, just like breathe for a second. Just remember something that isn't the constant
Work,
rush and like
yeah.
this constant need to like consume everything instantaneously. It's like, even now, if there is a good show out, I hope that I don't know about it for like 2 years and then I can just watch it all. You know what I mean? Like, when I
Yeah.
know something maybe is good and not gonna like waste my time and just like keep me so uninterested, I don't.
It takes a lot to get me to watch a movie these days because I get so mad if I spend 2.5 hours watching it and it sucks. I'm like, that's 2.5 hours I'm never gonna get
Like, I could have
back.
been doing so many
Yeah,
other
so many other
things.
things. So many other things.
Yeah, and
Ugh.
it feels like there's, but it, in on the same note, it's kind of been a good thing because I feel like I've been utilizing my time way more
Of
effectively.
course, yeah.
So,
For sure, I'm sure.
I don't know. When I think back, like, I wasted so much time like on Netflix and stuff like that. And like the more I've been doing and the more busy that I've made myself, the less those things appeal to me anyway. So I think overall, I guess generally
It's
it's
not a
good
bad
because
thing,
just get
yeah.
away from the mind drain.
Yeah. Unless it's a Tom Segura comedy show, which is. I brought that home.
I am so
I made
excited.
the hubby watch one.
I'm
He
going.
passed the test. He laughed. I'm like, all right, you could stay.
Hell yeah.
You could stay.
No, that was, yeah, I'm glad that I got to share that with you.
Yes.
Yeah, but that's why even things like, that's why I like to watch things like comedy specials, for instance, because it's like, this is the amount of time and then it's over.
Yeah.
And if it's someone that you've like watched clips of or that you've, listened to podcasts of or whatever, you can generally guarantee that you're probably gonna like it. And if you turn it off because it sucks, then you don't fucking feel bad because you're like, that was it. I don't have to like,
I didn't commit to anything that
Yeah,
I have to watch again
exactly.
next time.
Yeah,
Yeah.
exactly. So, but yeah, and plus I'd rather just find something that will give me, some momentary like smiles and laughter
Yes.
to have in the background than to have to get so
Deep.
deep into like this drama that I don't fucking care about at all. And I'm just like, why am I fucking watching this? I
For
don't care about
sure.
these people. I have no connection to these characters at all. Because it all just feels like blech, like gray goo. I don't like it.
Gray goo.
Gray goo. Oh. I don't know. Maybe is this just what happens? Oh, it
Don't,
happens.
don't even say
Oh
it. Hey, don't even say it.
It
No.
happens. David, we're old. I hate everything. But no,
Those young
I feel
whippersnappers in there,
back in my
loud
day.
music.
No, but like I don't know. Like but I do think that there's some validity to what we're saying about like the rush of how fast all of the new stuff is coming out. Like even if that
Yeah.
stuff is potentially good, I think that there's just like too much of it.
Too
It's too
much.
fast and it's the content is very rushed. It doesn't feel genuine. It doesn't feel like an actual tribute to those things that it's built off of that we loved. So I guess even for us, there is probably more personal attachment to that and than the younger generation of people would have for sure. But at the same time, I think it also is taking away people's ability to just like appreciate waiting for something and having to
That have
not
wait for
necessarily
it.
earn something, but you feel like you earned something, when you like, I don't know, I always felt that way. Like I was a part of like the waiting process, especially when it was like the new Harry Potter movies or like whatever that, I was into when I was a kid. And there's no waiting anymore. It's like everything is now and it's,
So
I don't know.
I do have one show that I really like.
What is it?
And I appreciate it even more because I have to wait every week. It's not like Netflix where they release it all at once. It's one episode per week, just like the olden days. Mm-hmm. it is Star Trek Discovery on Paramount Plus. Mm-hmm. I am a Star Trek fan.
Yeah. And what's your favorite?
Next Generation.
Me too.
Of course. I grew up watching that at my family dinner table.
Boom. Love it.
And Picard is really good too on Paramount Plus. Picard.
I've heard of it.
Yeah, it's good. It's a little weird, but it's good. And he's old as fuck. But he still looks the same.
Does he?
No, he's finally starting to look old.
Yeah.
He's finally starting to look old.
He looked like that one way forever. Like, yeah. What's his fucking name? The Pink Panther. Steve Martin.
Yeah.
He, like, looked like that forever.
Steve Martin actually, like, Patrick Stewart looks kind of old now, but Steve Martin still kind of looks good. Like, I watched this show about a podcast that he's, what is it called? Only Murders in the Building. Mm-hmm. It's him and Martin Short and Selena Gomez. Very weird.
Yeah.
Very weird. But, he looks great, Steve Martin.
Does he?
Yeah.
I'm looking up Steve Martin.
He does. David, he looks great.
Put a picture of Steve Martin now.
He looks fabulous. And that was a cute little show. But, I was just saying that I do appreciate the streaming services that release one episode at a time. I do like that. I am a fan of that.
Yeah.
Make me wait at least a week.
Yeah.
Or if I, you know, I'll watch 2 weeks at a time if I skip 1 week or something. Or, you know, like 2 episodes in a row if I skip 1 week.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it's nice to have that.
Yeah, I have to wait, like.
Yeah, like, what's going to happen?
What's going to happen?
And you think about it and you anticipate it.
Yeah, like, oh, I can't wait till next week when I go out to the next episode.
Yeah.
At least there's that.
Yeah. That's why, like, yeah, everything, fuck. Maybe I am just old, or maybe it's because, like. Maybe it's because I work, like, as much as I do that I just feel it a lot more. But I just feel like there's such a rush behind everything.
Mm-hmm. No, like, it's true.
Behind everything and everyone. And there's, like, no slowdown. Like, when are we allowed to slow down and, like, you know, when are we allowed to take a moment?
You have to make that time.
Yeah, but that's also so difficult to do when you have so many obligations and responsibilities. And it's like, but then at the same time, if you don't have those... then it's even worse.
It's a double-edged sword. Yeah, that's what we call a double-edged sword.
Crazy balancing act.
Yes. But you have to make sure that you make that time for yourself.
Yeah.
Because how could you give all those other responsibilities your best if you're not taking care of yourself at least, you know, a little bit. You know,
I think there's also something to be said for delegating.
Yes, that's like, true.
Like, for instance, I appreciate all of David's assistance because this was driving me crazy, having to not only schedule guests, but then also edit it and be like so overly invested in it because it was like my thing. It was my extension of me. So obviously anything weird or bad or off negatively reflected on me. And it's like I couldn't do that
much.
And like
it's too much.
Now I feel much more relaxed about the process. I'm like, I'll just sit here and say stupid shit and he can
edit it together and make it look good. But also we are our own worst critics, so I'm sure you are editing it with such a critical eye.
Yeah,
you know, so that's stressful.
Yeah, because it's like I'm like, you gotta like,
it has to be perfect
on the first time every time. Like, it's like, it's never gonna fucking work like that. Stop.
It has to be
thinking
good.
That way.
It has to be the best.
But you know, it's like, even if you know that, it's you still get that, like, stress inside. I'm like, well, why isn't it perfect? Why am I garbage? And it's like, well, you're not. You're not garbage. You're just, like, this particular thing you didn't do right the first time. So just figure out how to do it and try again. Like, it's okay.
Try
but
as many times as
I can't do that in
need.
The moment. I just have to think about it later and be like, calm the fuck down, dude.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
It's hard to be reasonable to yourself sometimes.
Yeah.
You know?
You need somebody else to tell you how to be reasonable and then try to implement it. It's really hard. I don't know. Especially like, I don't know. Did you have like parents with very high expectations? Or like where, I'm curious because we both kind of have this like where a lot of your, like, I need to be the best. Like I have to, you know what I mean? Like, Because I've started to explore that within myself so I can try to like not be so hard on myself all the time.
I just feel like if I'm gonna do something, why not be the best at it? You know, like I don't, and but no,
But there
my
shouldn't be,
parents
but there
weren't,
shouldn't be stress
there
from that.
shouldn't, no, there shouldn't.
But you have the stress, and the stress comes from somewhere.
I feel like I have stress about everything, so it's just like another thing to have stress about.
Yeah.
But no, my parents, like, they expected me to do well, but they weren't like on my ass about getting straight A's or X, Y, or Z. You know, they weren't. I was the third kid, so by then they were just like, meh.
There it is.
Do what you want.
There it is.
Go for it. You
No.
want it? Meh,
Girl. There it is.
Oh.
That's why you want to be the best. Because by the time that you were the third kid, they were just
Oh,
like,
because nobody pays
done.
attention to me. That. Nobody pays attention to me.
Hey, me too. I talk to you. We're making breakthroughs here today. Come on, me. I pay attention to you.
Me.
Dude, I'm the
Oh,
same way.
shit.
No, I came to that realization because freaking.
Oh my God, what the
I was going through it. Dude, all right. So, for instance, I know that my mom isn't ever going to listen to this. And honestly, if she does, mom, I'm sorry, but this is just accurate. So, she doesn't talk to me. And I wasn't like the favorite kid. My brother was like the golden child, you know? And I love my brother very much. But that's how it was. And so, it's like I'm always trying to like just get the approval, get the attention, be the best. Like, look at the thing that I did. Ask about it for once, you know? Call, you
Yeah.
know?
Like, do you
And
care?
so, yeah. And so when it comes down to it, I'm like, oh, I'm like doing all these things to make my mom fucking notice me more or reach out more or like show the care. But it's like,
Interest?
yeah, interest. But
Yeah.
like the difference is it's like nothing that I do is going to do that. It's like that's going to come from her or it won't. And so I need to like start looking at it as just measuring it against myself, you know? But that's so hard to do when you've been like growing up through that, trying to always like look at this. And they're just like, ah, you know, good job. You know,
Like,
woo.
oh.
You know, you're like a little bit more. And then,
A
you know, but then you
little
get to the point where it's like, you know, but.
more.
But it's all just about, you know, trying to learn to appreciate yourself or even more so just appreciate the people who see you when the people that you want to see you don't. You know, because it's like if we're always looking for the approval or the validation from someone who isn't going to give it to us, then it's kind of like we're turning our backs on basically receiving that from the people who are trying to. And so I think that's been one of like the hardest things for me is coming to like that conclusion for myself, especially with my own mom. So it's yeah, it's oh, that's deep, bro. It's like, I don't know,
Bro,
I'm stoned.
bro.
Yeah, it sucks.
It's
But it's hard.
so
But the
interesting.
more that you think about it and the more you try,
Oh.
it's like, you know, my boyfriend even tells me all the time, it's like the brain is like a muscle, so it's like working out, you know. The more that you start to have experiences, the more that you train yourself to first stop and think about situations or to assess them. And it's like the more likely you are to keep doing that and to keep having those as the first impulses instead of the ones that you have to think about first. So I'm trying to think about it more that way and bring out a more rational side to it. But it's still so freaking hard to break those habits of like the self-deprecation, whether it comes from like abuse or neglect or any different sort of thing. Those are difficult things to overcome, and it takes time and work, and it's so difficult to get to a point where you could even be like, oh, this is why I feel this way, you know? And it's a big journey, but I think that, you know, exploring it more and trying to figure yourself out, you owe it to yourself to do that because we're here for a long ass time. And the
Hopefully.
happier, yeah, and the
Yeah.
happier you can be with yourself with the time that you have here, the better.
So true. So true. Wow. I feel like I'm in therapy session. This is serious shit.
If you want unsolicited advice, email twpodcast@gmail.com. email@gmail.com or leave me a voicemail at anchor.fm/twnt. Ask Molly while she's stoned.
Go ask Molly.
Don't take her advice unless it sounds good.
Sounds good. She makes it sound good.
I think that if you just talk a lot and use enough big words and you just keep talking long enough, you can convince people yourself that you know what you're talking about, too. People are like, oh, damn.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, did she hear
about it? She definitely knows what she's knows. Talking about.
What does she say? Ask her. Because I'm not even deep enough for her. Like, I can't. Like, it's all facade.
So interesting. I think the human brain is such an interesting place.
It is. And that's why, like, nobody's able to really figure out. It's like that's one of the most untapped sciences because it's just so very insanely complex.
So complicated.
Like, oh my God. Everyone is so individualistic, but on the same note, there's still so many vast similarities between how people think and perceive things. And it's just crazy, but then at the same time, like, you could have a doppelganger and never have the same full experiences as that person.
That's true.
You know, it's crazy.
Everybody has complete individual experiences.
Yeah. But, yeah, it's funny. It's even the same with, like pets but and the animals, same. Which is funny because it's just on a different level. It's just that humans are the most complex of that. Like, even my three dogs are also vastly different, in their own horrible, twisted ways.
Like, they're all the same breed. They're all dogs. Yes. They were all raised in similar fashions, but they are all their own individual personalities.
And they all suck, and I hate them.
No, that is not true. I love them they're so wonderful.
Much, but they're so bad sometimes, most of the time. No. But I love them. I spoil them too much.
They're wonderful.
Yeah. No, they've actually gotten so good this year. I've been doing so much work with them. That's one of the big things that I've done this year.
That's huge.
Less feral.
My dog is so rude. He has no leash manners whatsoever. I want to beat his ass.
What does he do?
He just fucking pulls us. I have to, like, wrap him up so on, like, such a short leash to get him to walk beside me.
Motherfucker. What kind of dog?
He's a Havanese Bichon mix.
He's a little bit dramatic.
He's wonderful. I love him so much. but he is very rude on the leash. And he does pee when people come in the house because he gets too excited, that little motherfucker.
Oh. Yeah, my Edward used to do that. He used to do that.
I want
to
beat that out of him. Yeah. I'm just kidding. I love I will never.
Yeah. But I think that everybody gets it. It's like that's how being a dog parent is. It's just like, what the fuck are you doing?
Again?
Oh, I love you so fucking much. You're so cute. Stop. And it's like all in the same breath because I just look at you. They're so cute. But it's like at the same time, you did destroy 5 pairs of shoes and there's shit on all of the rooms with carpet and nowhere on the hardwood floor. So,
oh my God, that's the worst.
You know, it's
it's the worst.
But the cool
spiteful
thing,
little shits.
But the cool thing about dogs versus children is when dogs fuck up shit, you can just put them in a cage.
Yep. You can't do that with a kid.
No.
You just definitely can't do that with a kid.
Just put them in the cage and you're like, you're bad. You're the worst. Bad dog. And then you put the blanket over it and you're like, bye. I don't have a dog for like a few hours. Like, you need to do it because they need to learn. And I was not disciplining them enough. And, you know, Ian was very good. The babies were not.
They're all wonderful.
They've gotten good now.
They're all wonderful. Is this chair heated?
Mm-mm.
Oh, it's just my hot body against it, I guess.
You're just so hot. Woo! But did we ever discuss the most exciting thing that you did sexually?
Oh, exciting.
Like, wild, like... Or, for instance, for those married mommies out there, things that you like to do to keep it.
Oh, well, yeah, we were talking
about
that.
That's what I was
that.
Saying.
Yeah, because, we were talking about that.
Like, not like the craziest, wildest, but like, what do you do to keep it crazy as crazy can be for married life? Sorry, I should have phrased that better.
I mean, actually, probably the craziest thing that we did, I look back on it and I'm like, oh my God, did we really do that? I don't know, should I? All right, whatever. Here we go. Sorry, babe.
Love you.
The craziest thing I think we did, which probably isn't even going to be that crazy.
Just wait, I'm like anticipating, like,
no, because like
she's gonna be like a butt plug.
I kind of like those, but
I do too.
So we wanted to like kind of explore. I don't really know what we really had in mind, but we went onto a website. What website was that? Like the famous
whatever it was for a community.
Yes, we
of
were
online people.
Something we were looking for. Something
we were didn't know for, what we were looking we didn't for know. When we started this search, but we sure found something.
Yes, precisely. And we ended up like connecting with another couple who lived very far away. I think they lived in like Detroit or something. I don't know. Very far from where we lived.
Shout out to Detroit.
Hey.
From my home state.
Yeah. Ooh. Oh, there you go. Oh, that's right. I forget. And we like kind of like had this online fling with like another couple.
Oh, like a sexting?
Yeah. Fling. Yeah.
Did you guys meet?
We never met in person, though. It was just online. But like we would like set up the camera. You know,
like watch each other have sex.
Yes. Ooh. We did that. And like,
how was that?
It was kind of fun.
Is that
it
what kind cool. of led you to thinking about doing this?
You know, it was like the early stages of a very long road that I've gone down. It was probably like the first like thing that like bigger thing that we kind of tried. And it was kind of cool. And it felt kind of safe because it was behind a camera. It was behind the computer or whatever.
That's what I've always loved about, like, webcamming and content creation is that, like, it's all, like, the naughtiness.
We didn't have to meet them in person.
Yeah.
But it was still, like, a cool experience. Because we're like, oh, my God, they're watching us.
I actually have a lot of couples on my fans-only page. Well, yeah, fun. So, yeah, I totally get that. But, yeah, it's
I mean, that's not for everybody, of course.
No.
But we had – it was something that – my hubby wanted to try, and he was open and honest about talking about it. Was we worked together to figure it out.
It's just like watching a porno.
Mm-hmm.
So if you think about it as they're kind of just watching you like a porn and you're watching them like a porn, then it's like that's kind of what it's for, right? Otherwise, like, what are you doing? It's hot. Like I think it's hot. Like, that's one of my things is kind of like exhibitionism. Like, I like being watched. It's like my That's my thing.
Like, how could you do what you do if you didn't?
I love it.
You know?
I'm an attention whore. But
well, now I think I know why I like attention so much, thanks to this talk with Miss Molly over here.
Thanks, Mom.
Yeah, right, exactly. Thanks.
You know, that's not even the fucking... That's not even cute. Like, you think, oh, daddy issues for sure.
No, he paid attention to me. My dad definitely paid attention to me.
I'm saying me.
No, I know. No, I'm saying it's mom.
Yeah.
You don't always think of it that way, but yeah.
Yeah. Like, they always think of, like, oh, like, the dad leaves beats
it's not
you
always the dad.
Sexually abuse you. Like, I'm sorry. Like, I love my mom so much. I really do. But it's just, most of the time, doesn't feel like I have one. I forget. Like, we haven't spoken in months. So it's just one of those things
Her
that
loss.
It's like, no, it's cool, but it's like you reach a point, I think, and I think everybody reaches this point in adulthood where you just realize that you have this idea of your parents in your head that they are just perfect for whatever reason. Like, you just worship them growing up for the most part, especially if there's nothing like on the surface that's just like, oh, like they're beating me or something.
Yeah, yeah. They're just like
manipulation
parents.
And abuse and even neglect are different things that go hand in hand. And a lot of people, you know, just... I don't think, and there's no handbook on how to be a perfect parent.
Right.
There isn't.
Right.
And, you know, I think that I know my mom loves me, and it's like, it is what it is. But it's just like, we can't have these expectations and put these expectations on other people just because we came out of their
Just because they're parents.
Genitals.
You realize that your parents are just also regular people.
Yeah, they're just people with problems like you and their own, and their own issues and their own things going on. And it's like, you can't expect them to always be invested in what's going on with you, just like anybody in life. And it's cool if they are, and it's awesome for them to be more present, but you just have to kind of accept, like, oh yeah, that's not gonna
that's
be
not
a thing.
This
we're not I'm not gonna be bestie, you know what I mean? Like, it's not, and And I don't think I would want that either. Like, it's not cool.
Like, oh, like, no, thanks.
I'm fine.
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah. But, yeah, I don't think. And I think that it's still good to have that in mind when we go forth and then try to realize that, yeah, it's still okay to have that kind of, like, be the best. But try to be the best, like, by the gauge of your ability to do so.
Yeah.
And accept the failures where they come, but use them as an opportunity to, like, watch those and learn from them and grow. And mm-hmm. and then be able to use those to learn how to, you know, fix that and move on. It's cool.
Yeah.
But that's just part of growing up. And I think everybody gets there in different levels of time. And I think some parents are still children. So.
Yeah. It's true. You think that becoming a parent just instantly, like, matures you, but it doesn't.
It doesn't. No. Life experiences and open-mindedness and acceptance are what make you grow, mm-hmm. and realizing that, you know, not everything is going to be the way that you see it in your head, whether it's, you know, what you expect your kid to be, mm-hmm. or what you know, what you expect them to do, or to, or things or failures in your own life, and putting those on, you know, because yeah. it's like everybody needs to accept some of their own personal responsibility for how things work out with friends or family or, you know, relationships, any of that stuff. Because mm-hmm. nobody's perfect, so.
Nobody's perfect. Not even Chris Hemsworth.
No.
Close, though. Close. I'm sure. I had to just throw that in there.
Close, though.
Close, though. But, yeah, okay, so what else? What else? Spicy, spicy, spicy. I mean, I guess, like, be willing to try new things even if it feels weird, you know. Yeah. That's the thing.
Was that, like, the weirdest thing that, like, for, like, especially at the start, or, like, I'm kind of curious, like, was he your first real sexual journeyman, basically, like your hubby, or mm-hmm.
yeah,
like, as far as, like, for instance, you said, oh, I like butt plugs, you know what I mean? Like, because nobody just goes into sex for the first time and they're like, damn, I fucking love butt plugs. Like, it comes from somewhere, you know what I mean?
I guess that, yeah, I guess, like, before hubby, it was more like just regular vanilla types of stuff with ex-boyfriends. Mm-hmm. My one ex-boyfriend and I love to have sex in the car all over the place. And, like, we did get caught a couple of times.
Yeah, did you get in trouble?
Oh, my God. Thank God we never got an actual, like, ticket.
Yeah.
But, like, we were so dumb and young and stupid. And that yeah. was so stupid.
I think we all do that shit at some point.
That was so stupid.
Oh, my God.
But that was fun, though. Like, also, like, the feeling yeah. of getting, like, oh, we might get caught.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I know. Girl, I feel you. Yeah. You get it, yeah. So but it's fun. I don't know. There's something fun about having an audience. Like, oh, yes, watch. Don't touch, watch. Watch me. And it's fun, but I don't know. I don't know what turns me on about it, I guess. I guess it goes back to my attention seeking.
Yeah, that's it.
But I don't know. But I have fun with it. And especially now that I'm having quality sex that I enjoy having, mm-hmm. whether it's on camera or
and
off
it's so
camera,
different.
It's kind of like
yeah.
you can just enjoy and explore it more. And it takes it, and that's why exploring, like, and what I said earlier about, like, if you have a kink or a fetish and you have to talk to your partner.
My stomach is growling really loud. Sorry. Sorry. Hungry.
But you have to talk to your partner about it. It's so important because if you can find someone you're compatible with, then you can really grow and explore and learn with the other person, and you might find things that you align with or things that you're willing to try even further with someone else, like mm-hmm. but it's all about, you know, that communication, which so many people lack. And I think there's a lot of bad sex happening because people aren't talking.
I agree. I really truly feel like if people would talk about it more,
yeah,
they would enjoy it so much more. Yeah. And it would be more of a thing. And mm-hmm. then you wouldn't be so angry that other people were having good sex. Because you could also have good sex. Just talk about it. Communication.
There's so many things that I didn't know that I liked.
There you go.
Like, ooh. Like, you gotta try some shit out, my dudes. Yeah. But also, you have to do it in a way that, like, respect somebody else's boundaries too, because I've also been put in situations where there was so much sex I didn't enjoy because it was not in a situation that I was comfortable in or wanted to be a part of or really given opportunity to turn down.
So
it was kind of like, you know, but that's why like consent is super important, like actual full consent, not like I'm doing this because you're manipulating me into doing it. Like full respect, like just fucking respect people, because for whatever it is that you're into, there is somebody else out there who's into it. So, and who will be into you, because there's a lot of fucking people in the world. So just like fucking be respectful of people. Like you can have such better fucking sex. I don't understand. I don't understand why it's such a hard concept.
Sucks.
Yeah. Anyway. So, actually, I think that we have been going an hour, so if you would like to get some food, since we do have some very fun plans this evening, would you like to tell everybody where they can find you on the social media or any of your stuff that you want to plug? Anything coming?
Yes. If you are interested in subscribing, you can find me at Lexi K, LexiiKay, on the fans page and on Instagram. No, on Instagram, I'm Flexi K.
Because she's very, very, very flexible.
Yes.
She has some very cool photos. I love
following. More coming. More coming.
You're embracing your inner yogi.
I'm definitely going to be posting more of
that. Inner yogi. There we go. I said it.
Yes. Yoga goddess.
There we go.
Yes.
All right.
So yeah, Flexi K, and on Clapper, which is a really cool app. It's if you don't know what it is, it's like a 17 and up app, which has the same kind of platform as TikTok, but it's more adult oriented. So the lives there get really fun, and the content there is a little more spicy, and we have more freedom to post what we want, which is really cool. And I'm Lexi K there as well. And yeah.
Awesome.
That's it.
And do you have any final words to leave with our guests this evening? Anything? And it can be anything that you want to say.
Smoke weed every day.
Thank you for liking, thank you for subscribing, and we will see you next week.
Bye.